We are a COVID-19 testing lab that has developed its own assay to perform high throughput testing of the community in general, starting with first responders. We are 4 times as fast as the CDC method. Per day, per machine, we're actually able to run 1,200 samples a day.
My name is June Axup. I'm scientific director and partner at IndieBio, startup accelerator based in San Francisco and New York. Renegade Bio started out in San Francisco and are now also working in New York as well. Both of you were actually alumni of IndieBio and towards the end of February, beginning of March, decided to drop everything you were doing and start Renegade. What drew you to that?
Once the pandemic was declared and we realized that the CDC released their primary sequences, we were like, we need to do this. Like, we have the capabilities to do this. And we jumped on it and started doing it.
Yeah. Without any hesitation.
People probably have heard about qPCR as being the standard technology. People are now hearing about the serological tests. What kind of technology do you use?
We detect virus using quantitative reverse transcription PCR. In our assay, the results are very clear. When someone's positive, they're positive. When someone's negative, they're negative. The limit of detection for our assay is 10 copies per microliter.
At the beginning, when the CDC started, there was really all about the nasal swab, and people still consider that the highest quality swabs. But because of the discomfort, you know, people don't really want to go there. So now we're starting to collect, you know, oral pharyngeal swabs, and we've actually detected virus in sputum.
The state of testing, of course, was extremely dire in the U.S. We were extremely late to the game, even though we had quite a bit of a head start. What do you see is like the state of diagnostics right now?
First of all, opening up testing to a broader community is really important on the regulatory side. Currently, New York State is trying to get to 40,000 tests per day. Our current Renegade Bio capacity is 1,440 tests per day. And the Renegade Bio capacity in 10 days will be 5,760 tests per day, representing about 14.4% of the total New York State capacity.
Now, we've tested a few serological tests right now, and the quality of those are really not that great.
The antibody tests are just not cutting it right now. And furthermore, we don't know about the antibodies. We don't know if they're protective. We don't know how long they're protective, if they are protective. Like, saying that you've been exposed to the virus is one thing, but knowing whether or not you're going to infect someone else is where we need to be to stop the spread of the virus. So viral testing is going to remain at the forefront for a while.
What's it like in New York right now? You know, from the news, from the numbers that we see every day, it just seems extremely horrific. How do you feel being in New York?
I mean, it's surreal. You know, there's no traffic. Never in my life did I think I would come to New York, rent an SUV, and drive it freely throughout Manhattan. The testing, the governor of New York released a executive order stating that there's going to be a statewide coordinated effort to test everyone. And so they are, you know, working to deploy that. Seeing people come together, seeing people try to tackle this problem, seeing people work hard has been really inspiring. I'm a little concerned. Things seem to be opening much more quickly than they should be.
The weather is not helping, right? It's like after a long winter, people are starting to see the sun coming out, and you know, you can see everybody being out and about. So considering the numbers still here in New York, that's definitely a risk.
Tell me a little bit about putting together a team, because you guys grew extremely rapidly, and obviously the people who are coming to work on this are feeling a huge sense of purpose during this time.
The team naturally assembled. I mean, we grew from 0 to 25 people in less than a month, right? A couple of weeks, actually. I mean, we are very fortunate to have a tremendous network, mostly through IndieBio folks, but also me personally, having experienced so many different community aspects in the Bay Area. So it was really easy to ping people that I knew were really good, or they came to me and were like, hey, I want to help you. So yeah, it was very natural. And I think really the SOSV network, the IndieBio network, has really facilitated our growth. So it's awesome. Thank you, SOSV.
Thank you for doing the frontline work that is much needed right now.